Sometimes our heritage and history can be found in extremely interesting places. For instance, the eBay website. My name is Peter Grauer, and we're at the corner of 1st and Victoria Street in downtown Kamloops. The end of the 19th century was a very different era visually for Kamloops. The only remnant building left from that era is the old Bank of Commerce building at the corner of 1st and Victoria Street. It is now occupied by the Brownstone Restaurant. It was in this building that Robert Serva spent part of his career before he left for the Yukon and into the pages of Canada's literary history. It was also in this building in 1905 that Bill Miner went inside to cash a $1,000 bill from the Bank of Oklahoma. When Miner and 15-year-old Albert McKay were waiting for the bank to open that day in 1905, they crossed over Victoria Street to where a saddlery or tack shop was located. They admired the saddles for display in the front windows. Today, the location of this saddle shop is a vacant lot and the spot for Kamloops' latest urban garden. In the recent memory of many, it will be remembered as the Whitmore Secondhand Store. Recently, a photo appeared on the internet website of eBay. This photo was brought to my attention by Joyce Klassen, a Kamloops resident who specializes in collecting Kamloops memorabilia. I am confident that the saddlery shown in this photograph is in the same location as Whitmore's secondhand store used to be. However, without a considerable amount of additional research, we can't be positive. The photo was put up for auction on eBay by an unknown owner just recently. The winning bid for this piece of Kamloops heritage went for $75, a mere pittance, and it went to a buyer in Vernon. This unique view of our Western heritage has now been lost for the foreseeable future. These low-resolution renditions of the photo were obtained from the eBay website. It is unfortunate that Kamloops does not have the program, budget, or initiative to obtain photographs, documents, and artifacts that are so vital to our history. Much has already passed into foreign hands, where it is unavailable to future researchers and art and cultural historians.
We can have a certain degree of confidence that this indeed is a Kamloops saddlery, as the pennant behind the counter proudly displays the name. This photo was posed for the camera, as exposure times in those days were very long, and each person had to remain absolutely still. The man behind the counter may have been the owner. However, this would have to be checked in a contemporary directory. Also, the tongue and groove wall finishing is reminiscent of Whitmore's store, which had retained some of this facing until demolition. The details seen with an intensive study of this photograph reveal a store heavily stocked with items pertaining to horses, riders, and teamsters. As well, leather items such as suitcases are also available. It reflects a time in the history of Kamloops which depended totally upon the horse for personal and local transportation, as well as for horsepower. It also reflects a time when people moved at a slower pace, able to be close to the land and to each other. As time passes, photos like this one, detailing a part of Kamloops' past heritage, are getting rarer and more valuable. All of us should look closely at the photos in our own and in our parents' collections.
In this era of scanning and digitization, the sharing and copying of photographs should be easily available to everyone that is interested in our history. I'm Peter Grauer, and in a future episode in this series, we will feature a vignette on the care and copying of photographs and documents.